Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for summer 2019-20. December is likely to be hotter and drier than average, with a good chance the monsoon will be delayed for tropical Australia. However, the drier than usual pattern is likely to ease as summer progresses. But first, let's look at recent conditions. It's been exceptionally dry across most of the country, with spring being one of the driest on record for Australia. At the end of October, we did see good rain in southern Queensland and northwest New South Wales. Bourke recorded 95 millimetres in just 24 hours. However, this has had little impact on water storages. Spring also brought many extremely warm days. Most states had daytime temperatures in the top 10 warmest on record. A number of locations saw their hottest November day on record, while most of the mainland topped 40 degrees at least once during November. As a result, soils are very much drier than average across most of the country. Only soils in northern New South Wales and southern Queensland are currently wetter than average. Bushfires and raised dust continue to affect the mainland, the result of the dry landscape and persistent hot winds. In some places, smoke haze and dust reduced visibility for several days. The dry has meant low river flows were recorded at 89% of locations in November. This is the highest number of low flows recorded in at least the past decade. As a result, most mainland water storages are close to or below half full going into summer. So what will influence our climate in the coming months? The monsoon trough has yet to reach the southern hemisphere after a record late retreat from India. This increases the likelihood of a delayed start to the wet for tropical Australia. A delayed monsoon also increases the risk that a positive Indian Ocean dipole will not break down until midsummer, which is much later than normal. A positive IOD typically means drier and warmer than average weather for many areas and increased bushfire risk for the southeast. Lastly, a negative southern annular mode, or SAM, is likely to remain until at least late December. This increases the risk of more westerly winds than usual, which bring hot and dry air into eastern Australia. So what does this mean for the outlooks? December is likely to be drier than usual for most of Australia. However, the dry signal should ease over summer as the IOD and SAM patterns break down. While parts of Western Australia are likely to see above average rainfall, we're unlikely to see widespread rain in the east. November to January stream flows are expected to remain below average for most forecast locations. While temperature outlooks suggest that days are very likely to remain warmer than average across southern and eastern Australia. This means the risk of heat waves and bushfires continues to be high. So in summary, summer is likely to see many areas remaining drier than average, a late arrival of the northern rains, warmer than average days, low stream flows at most locations, and an increased risk of heat waves and bushfires. Thanks for joining us. You can find out more about the outlooks on our website. We'll see you next time.